that the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, we have come together to celebrate the wedding anniversary of Solomon and Jerica. As we join them in their joy and happiness, we also join them in thanksgiving and gratitude to God for all the many blessings they receive from God, especially in their faithfulness to one another as husband and wife. Let us pray for them that they remain committed and faithful to one another as they do to God. Lord Jesus, you come together into the nations, into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament, which strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory and salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading is taken from the first letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Follow the way of love, even as Christ loved you, taking himself for us, as God loved your wives, as Christ loved the church. He gave himself up for her to be her holy, purifying her in the bath of water by the power of the word, to present himself a glorious church, holy and immaculate, without stain or wrinkle or anything of that sort. Husbands should love their wives as they do their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. Observe that no one ever hates his own flesh. He nourishes it and takes care of it as Christ cares for the church, for we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother, and he shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall be made into one. This is the great foreshadowing, I mean that it refers to Christ and the church, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Glorify the Lord with me. Let us all together extol his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me, and he delivered me from my fears.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading is taken from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. There is no greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer consider you slaves, for a slave does not know what his master is about. Instead, I call you my friends, since I have made known to you all that I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me. It was I who chose you to go forth and let you. Your fruit must endure, so that all what you have asked of my Father in my name, he will give you." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Married life in the Catholic Church had been attacked left and right. The Catholic religion has been attacked. And the Catholic Church has been attacked left and right. The Catholic religion has been attacked throughout the world. There must be something in this religion why it is being attacked. My dear friends, this morning, why am I saying this morning? It is because when we speak of married people, especially in the Philippines, mostly Catholic people, 85% Catholics in this country, and yet they lead, most of them, they live a kind of a married life that is far away from God. They become too materialistic and consumeristic. That the family is already provided. This is very real. And this is a reality in the Philippines today. When many married people are more engrossed to material things rather than to take care of their lives. And it's very, very sad to say that these are Catholics. When we speak of married life, it is sealed with love and blood. The protein that seals married couples, blood and love. When two people love together, a man and a woman, it is really true love to so come together and be married, whether it's in other religion or other religion, they are married. And when we speak again about married life, it is founded on the Holy Sacrament of matrimony, and it is founded on love. People say, I cannot trust my wife, I cannot trust my husband. Why? Because you do not love one another. And after marriage, after the sacrament of matrimony, after marriage, now they live together. They call one another a husband and wife. And because they are called a husband and wife, they are now linked to one another. They are no longer two, but they are one. In mind and heart. Mother Vanilla, alam mo to stay in the silence of these people. Mother Vanilla, magtiayon na kita pa doon. Kung sa tuka, ang akong pamanapunan, lahat ng mga lagi ang pamanapunan sa pagmahal ng pagkalaan. At my dear people of God, Mother Vanilla, duha kita magkatayang mo sa kinabuhin ninyo. Tatlo, a husband and wife should be united in mind and heart. There is no better things in this world than a husband and wife united in mind and heart, giving as one. Salam and Angelica. You are united during the marriage ceremony. You are now united, mind and heart, giving as one. And this is the foundation of every married couple give me a sign. You are no longer born, but you are one in mind and eyes. Finally, I am sharing with you this morning. And I will just say to Solomon and Angelica this morning, I know you have different personalities and nationalities also. Filipino and Solomon from Switzerland, very, very proud. And yet, Solomon and Angelica, you are now connected one and one another, to make it as one, to unite it as one, even though with different nationalities, even if you with different languages, and yet, love does not say it, whatever nationalities, love always dies. The very essence of God, it does not say any language, it does not say nationalities, because God loves everyone.
May God bless you. So we press the name Solomon and the name
of the East End. Please join the right hands together. I express your intention before God. And I, the Reverend Father, Felisardo Arquebayan, by the authority of the Church, calling on all those present here as witnesses, confirm and let the renewal of marriage vows which you have made in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God and God and Father, we bless and praise your name. In the beginning, you created man and woman, so that they may enter communion of life and love. You likewise bless a union of Solomon and Angelica, so that they may reflect a union of Christ in his church. Look with favor and kindness of their king. Amidst the joys and the struggles of the life, you have preserved this union that we have. Renew the marriage covenant and increase your love in them. This then, dear children, and this we ask for Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please stand for the prayers of the faithful.
Unity and eternity in the Son and the Holy Spirit, in oneness of life and communion of love. When the priests are mindful of the covenant of love, they pledge to each other through the sacrament of marriage and never fall into unity. For this we pray, Lord, have mercy. God's name. In your providence, you have ordained that all heavenly human experiences should become ways of living the faithful, to share in a mystery of Christ. Grant to your servant serenity in good times and in time and the will to stay close to Christ and to live for Him alone. For this we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. It is your will that marriage likes to be a lesson in Christian living. Grant that all husbands and wives may be witness to the wonders of your Son's love. For this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our dear brothers and sisters may receive eternal reward. For this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Thank you.